Prepare for war.
Che ne si prepara a guerra.
And prepare his defenses.
O che ne si prepara le difese di Dio.
We can never know what God would have wanted Solomon to do if he did not spend all his energy and all those expenses for those large building programs.
Aħna ma nafux seba' kien alla intenzjonata li jekk huma nifaqxa tilflus ta' tilprogrammi ta' bini kbar.
He spent his resources on things that were not in God's will.
Nifaq ħafna flus f'rizorsi li ma kienux fil-rida tagħna.
God had promised
Alla kien wieħed il-paċi.
During Solomon's reign.
Wieħed il-paċi dwar il-perjodu ta' renju ta'
Now last week we said that peace was something impossible in those days, as it is impossible today, as it seems. But God promised peace. Could Solomon believe the word of God? That God would offer peace where there was no peace?
Se taj jammelit il matalla Salamun illi għalla se taj fiom il-faċi fil-zmin fej ma taċi
kol-faċi. Now, what would say about the logic will tell you impossible.
Ma logika, se taj dinna motiv.
But you don't live by logic.
Ma ħna nejxuġ
bi. We live by obedience to God's word.
Aħna rridu nejxuġ.
That is faith. That is faith.
Dikki għal-fidi.
Now, we are promised that we're going to live in heaven. Are we believing it? Do we need more faith or less faith than Solomon? To believe the
things.
We know that God promised us peace with Him for eternity. He promised us the new Jerusalem that will come down from heaven. He promised us that we see Him as He is. He promised us that there will be no crying and no sickness, nothing else of those days. Are we believing that? Are we believing that? So if we believe that, Solomon could believe the word of God in the same place. Abraham believed.
Abraham.
It was counted for him as righteousness.
Okay, just.
Imagine Abraham.
Imagine Abraham.
Look in the Iran of today.
Actually,
he lived in the Iran of today.
Uesh, the Iran fallo.
And God said to him, go west, for the land that you walk on, I will give it to you and your descendants.
What are you doing? Elsa, Elsa, Elsa.
And I give the land to you and your descendants. Did God keep His promise? Until today, God kept His promise. Regardless of all the opportunities, regardless of all your positions, God's people have their land.
In the land
and they will have it to the full when Jesus returns. That is God's promise. We know the people of faith that walk on the land. How many of us would believe or obey God if God walk on the land and the world will fall? I would say to myself, I need to have some bills. But thank God, Joshua didn't think like that. Joshua obeyed. And the force of Jericho did fall. And the promise of Abraham in the land started. All we need to do, contrary to Solomon, is walk in faith. Most of us started good and stopped. It's time to go back from where we left and go forward. Many Christians do that all over the world. And we are not singled out with a special protection. All we need to do is encourage each other and what